Hello, I'm Bill Wong with Electronic Design. I love to read eBooks, and of course an eReader is the best way to do it. But these days, they can be in color, not just in black and white. Tim, could you tell us a bit about the new technology that you have that's even more robust than in the past?
Sure. We announced our advanced color platform several years ago, and we've been working to continue to innovate on it. So in December, so just recently, seven companies announced they're going with our Gallery 3 film to bring full color into those eBooks, into that eReader space. And so this is tens of thousands of colors on your display, full color, and the black and white experience is still as good as you remember.
Now, it's not just straight static displays. It's obviously not full movie quality, but you can actually make things change and interact with it.
Yes, we're not trying to make movie screens here. We've still leaned heavily into the benefit of the reading application, mm-hmm. the low power device that has months, not hours, of battery life to it. But yeah, color's been in demand for a long time, and we're really pleased to be bringing it out.
Now, how does the technology implementation differ from the previous generation?
Of the color one?
Mm-hmm.
So the general idea of the technology, it has multiple pigments that combine to form the different colors, mm-hmm. is the same. Our ability to engineer those pigments, so design them to function exactly how we want them, and specifically to control them, is now, we went from about 20 to 30 seconds per update, mm-hmm. to about half a second to a third of a second per update. So almost two orders of magnitude improvement on our ability to control how quickly and how vibrant that image goes out.
So that means things like page turning, making notes, things like that are now much more responsive.
Yes, 20 seconds is not a consumer device for me, it's too slow. But we really targeted getting it down to what's expected for that device.
Okay. So what are some of the form factors that we're going to expect? Is it primarily going to be for smaller e-readers, or are there any size restrictions for other applications?
Generally, we're starting with an 8-inch size in most of the applications. Mm-hmm. We'll be rolling out several new sizes as we continue to go forward. There's no fundamental limit. So most of our core material we make in a roll. So imagine a kilometer.
That's a big e-reader.
Exactly. So it gets cut in piece parts. So it has a lot to do with thinking about the weight of something you might want to read for an hour,
mm-hmm.
getting the size or the handhold factor down so that you can work with it. And that's more of the design than it is specifically the ink size.
Yeah. Well, I was thinking more of, you know, advertisements or things of that nature where, you know, larger size is more applicable.
Yep. We are doing that. We've been leaning heavily into color for retail and for smart city type applications. Mm. We're going up to 42-inch in many of those applications. We do have several products in the 25 to 28-inch diagonal range.
Very nice.
And we're bringing this platform into the general space of signage as well.
Very good. Well, thanks for filling me in on the latest color e-ink technology.
Excellent. I hope you read an ebook on it.